If you are into research, you might have come across times when your supervisor asked you to write a research paper. If this is your first time, you might be clueless or even worried about what it is and how to write one. Previously, I have made a video on how to write a review paper from the scratch, which has become very popular among students and researchers. After which, I received several requests from my followers for creating a video on how to write a research paper. So here it is. Doing research and performing experiment is science, but writing a great research paper is an art. In this video, you are going to learn this art of writing a research paper from the scratch. Today I will cover what is a research paper, why is it important to publish your research, major components of a paper, and at last, how to write your own research paper. I will share some of the unique techniques and few pro tips that will help you write research paper easily. So don't skip this video and watch till the end. So let's get started. Research paper, also known as research article, is a piece of paper that describes the original experiments you performed and major findings of your work. Now, why is it important to publish your research paper? Unless the experiments you did are published, no one in the world except you would know and recognize your work. Therefore, it is important to publish your research in a peer-reviewed journal. A paper properly reviewed by competent professors and scientists suggests that the research was scientifically conducted and reliable. Once published, it gives you the credit that you were the first one to do that research, and also others can read and cite your findings. The data you published can be useful for others to carry out subsequent research. Also, for the award of graduate degree, publishing at least one research paper or more is mandatory in most universities. Moreover, publishing a great research paper provides you an edge over others during interviews for academic and scientific positions. This way, publishing a paper is beneficial both for the authors as well as the readers. So now you know the benefits of publishing a paper. Now let's see what are the major components of a research paper. Here is an example of a published research paper. You can see the title, this is the author information, their affiliation or the place where the research was conducted. Next comes the abstract or summary, then the introduction, material methods, result and discussion, acknowledgements, author contribution, and at last, bibliography. I will be explaining about each of these sections in a moment. What most students do is they directly jump to start writing a research paper without even knowing or understanding their data. This way, they do finish their paper, but it lacks several things that are key for a quality paper. By quality, what I mean is the readers may not understand why the research was done, what was its significance, what were the major findings. Also, it will take longer to write a paper. If you follow all the points that I'm going to mention, I'm sure you will come up with a great research paper that can be easily published in a suitable journal. Now, if you want to write a research paper, I believe you already know what you have done, why you have done it, and how you did the experiments, what's new in your work, and its significance. So let's see where to start writing the paper from. Everyone has a different idea about writing a manuscript. But according to me, preferably it should start with material and methods or the results. Why? You will find an answer at the end. As you already know the material involved, the methods you followed, and the techniques or approaches you used, so I recommend you to first start with materials and methods, describing them in appropriate details. Mention details about the materials used, replicates taken, protocols followed, reaction setups, statistical and computational analysis. If any modifications were done in the existing protocols or the methods, the same should also be mentioned here so that the others can reproduce the experiments you have done. When following well-known methods, always cite the relevant papers. You may also provide a link to the online tool used during your analysis. While writing, recall what methods you used sequentially. This way, it would be easier for readers to follow your work in the right sequence. Once finished writing materials and methods section, go for the result section. First, prepare and finalize figures, tables, and supplementary information to be provided along with the paper. This will help you to know the visible outcome of your experiments. Then you may write the text of the result section. Follow the same sequence for the results as you did for the materials and methods. Refer and provide sequential number to the figures and tables at the suitable places in the text so that the reader can correlate the results section with what is given in the figures, tables, or the supplementary information. Always check the journal guidelines for maximum figure or table limits, the length of the manuscript. Based upon this, you may include or exclude or shift the less significant results to the supplementary information. Coming on to the discussion part, it needs a scientific temperament to write a good discussion. It is worth to know and highlight what new you found through your study, how your findings are useful for the science and scientific community. For this, it is very, very important to understand your results first. What your results are trying to reveal. If you have done literature review properly, you can easily discuss and argue your results in the light of previous findings. So here is a pro tip for you. Always discuss your results with your colleagues and supervisor. You can also give a lab presentation for this. This is important because you may not see the limitations with your experiments and data, but others can easily point it out. They may also suggest some improvements or point out an interesting inference out of your results that can add more strength to your paper to be published in a good journal. So listen to them carefully. You can also include a model or a hypothesis based on the results if promising. Conclude your paper by mentioning its future prospects based on your findings. You should also mention the implications of your work. After all this, you are now ready to write the introduction of the paper. Mention a brief background to introduce readers to your topic, species studied, its importance. Highlight the knowledge gap or the unanswered puzzle. What approach you use to address these challenges. Why I asked you to write the introduction after results and discussion is because you can now mention at the end of the introduction what key work you have done in this paper according to the inferred results. This excites and compels the readers to read your paper further. That's why I prefer writing introduction after results and discussion section. Once finished with the major sections, you can write a brief summary or the abstract of your paper. Here you mention only key things about your paper, a line or two about the background, what you have done, approach you have used, and at last some of the key findings of the research. Choose a suitable title that summarizes your whole paper in a single sentence. Remember not to overgeneralize the title. Based on the contribution of the individual authors, a list of authors and their affiliations are added. Fundings and minor contributions are acknowledged in the acknowledgement section. References include the research articles, reviews, books, or the chapters that were referred or cited in this paper. You may use reference managers like Mendeley or the EndNote for automatic formatting of the references. It saves a lot of time. A great research paper is not written in a single day. It requires persistent efforts. And here comes a pro tip number 2. Break the aim of the whole paper into small pieces of tasks. When you complete a task, mark it done. You can also make an Excel sheet for it to record your progress. This will help you to keep motivated to write quickly. So that's all for today's video. If you are planning to write a review paper, I highly recommend you to watch my video in which I have shared some of the most useful information that you may not find elsewhere. I have also made a dedicated video on how to choose a right research or PhD topic. I have also shared some of the useful tips on how to publish research articles quickly. All the links are given in the description below. Still, if you have any specific request, you can comment me below. I will try to answer it or make another video on it. If you find the video useful, do hit the like button and share with others. Subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified about my latest uploads. Do check my playlist on diseases and immunity, markers, techniques, and research. And finally, thanks for watching.